There's a ghosty in here.
I suppose we found our machine. At least, what's left of it. Do you feel anything, Saira? With your gift, I mean.
Saira? What? Nothing, no, but this thing looks familiar somehow. We should take a look around.
Agreed. Maybe we can even take some small parts of it with us right now.
Maybe.
The Order will transport the rest to Ark by Myrad.
Sure. Marius, you have a very feminine voice.
What strange metal. It didn't rust at all, despite ghosty. All the time it's been here.
I hear the ghosty. Pyrene Scout. 11, Enchanting 25. I do have Enchanting 25. Oh. It turned red. Is that a good thing? It turned red? Oh. We've got goop. Strange dynamo. Oh!
All this energy. It's useless without the Numinos.
Numinos? It needs a Numinos. Numinos. There was a third part I had to find. Oh, I can't get in there, huh? Numinos. I found this thingy.
Yes? Found something?
Yep. You just call me Saira. What kind of nickname is that, anyway?
Oh, I did. I'm sorry. Saira is Kymanian and can mean a lot of things, but the closest translation in our case would be sister-in-arms.
Aww.
My foster father called me that, so I suppose it's just an old habit. I like the way it sounds, though. If you don't mind, I'll call you that from now on.
Sure. I found something. This looks useful, whatever it is.
Yes? Yes, you're right. How is it possible that it moves all by itself? Let's take it with us.
Okay. Now what?
Yes? Found something?
I already gave it to you. Now what do we do? Find the second. Oh, there's more parts. Okay. Look around. Oh. Did we come this way? Depths. I guess we came from this way then. Yeah, we did. You're heading back up to where I find this dynamo part. More parts. Something's stopping me from going that way. Oh, there's more stuff down here. Maybe another part. Old parchment? Wimbrosia? Spell tome for flame bite. Steel sword of the blaze.
It works in a way we have not even come close to comprehending. Like a cosmic force.
I end up back here. Oh, I'm still here. Never mind. So we need one more part. What was that? Oh, hanging moss. Found something else.
Yes? Found something?
Yep. What about these parchments?
They look useful. Let's take them to the Chronica.
Okay. Where's this other part? Can we get up there somehow? Something in here, maybe, but I can't really advance inside it. Yeah, I found another soul, another ghostie. Where's this last part? Oh, a crystal.
Correct. Nothing else possesses that much raw, magical power.
Guess what? I found something else. Hey.
Yes? Found something?
Look what I found. Does this seem useful?
Let me see. Yes, it does indeed. Seems to be some kind of energy storage, but it's empty.
Yeah. I think that's all we need for now. We can let the Yorder take the rest.
Yes, I think you're right. Hopefully we didn't miss anything. Let's go talk to Pegast.
Okay. Report to Lashari about the find.
Yes?
Hey, you. Found some stuff.
Now that was quick. So, what did you find?
You were right. There is a machine back there. Or at least, there was one once. The years have certainly taken a toll on it.
Well, that's not much of a surprise, considering how long it was down here. And as long as we can reconstruct it, that's all right. I sent some of my men back to Ark. We'll request a caravan to get all the parts back to the temple, and see what we can do from there.
Okay.
Let's just hope it really will help us against this cleansing, whatever it is. As much as I admire Pyrean technology, I don't like the idea of putting our lives in the hands of it.
Yeah, we found this old parchment near the machine. Can you give us a little insight into what it really is?
Let me see.
Grab. Say again?
Interesting. Truly interesting.
What?
Seems that this machine was only some kind of prototype. The real one the Pyreans were working on must be somewhere else.
Oh,
plus,
boy.
There's also a name for it. The Pyreans called it the Beacon.
Oh, the Beacon? Are you kidding?
That's poetic.
Indeed.
The Beacon.
Well then, it seems like you and your visions have once again saved the day, Prophetess. There's a lot for us to do now. If you've taken care of your business here, I suggest you head back to Ark and report to Old Arantheal.
What do you think, Saira? Do you want to leave now, or stay a little longer?
Oh, we can leave now. I think we've pretty much seen everything we can. I wish my little friend here wouldn't be always standing between us. A beacon, though, really? Alright, let's go.
Good. There you are. Pegast's mages have already told the Grandmaster about our find, and they're waiting for us in the Emporium. Let's go.
Okay. You're busy. Well, so am I, lady.
All that I am saying is that there are more efficient ways to battle this red madness. And heathen machines atop the Sun Temple are the last thing that will calm the town.
I'll take this seat, thank you.
Maybe. But if this heathen machine is what the Pyreans used to combat the cycle, I want it near. Even if it turns out to be useless, only a fool turns down a chance. Sharim, how long will the reconstruction take?
Well, that depends on how many Pyrean mechanics you have on hand that can help us decipher these plans. Just think for once, Arantheal. How are we supposed to give you an estimation if we don't even know what the finished machine is supposed to look like?
We will get to work right away, Grandmaster. But in any case, we're going to need a lot of steel and Pyrean crystals.
You will get them. Now get to work.
Me?
You did excellent work. We will reconstruct this machine, no matter the price. Here, this will reward you for your effort. With a beacon and the sigiled stone, we now have both a sword and shield against these high ones.
Thanks.
It is more than I had hoped for. However, there has also been a disquieting development. I have called in a conclave, and it will take place in a day. Come back then, and use the time to rest. Walk blessed, prophetess.
Bless you.
What do you want, urchin child?
Urchin child? You can't tell me what your problem is with me?
My problem with you? I don't have a problem with you. I have a problem with what you stand for.
I don't stand for anything.
Tell me, prophetess, who built this temple? Which you enter and leave as frivolously as a sailor leaving a brothel.
How else would I enter and leave, but...
What did Malphas say to Dalcidocious after he succeeded in suppressing the Blood Moon Riot?
Dalcidocious? He said, awesome. Good work. What is this, an interrogation?
How goes the 100th verse of the Holy Path, which the novices have to recite each morning? What is the holiest tenet of the creed to every keeper of the sigil? Why is only the highest commander of the guard allowed to enter the temple?
Watch your tone, lady.
Don't you dare tell me what to do inside these walls.
I will.
You know nothing, neither of our faith nor of our country. And only because you happen to have strong magic in you, Arantheal thinks that justifies desecrating our traditions.
I'll take that
do
up with him.
Do you know how few Enderalaeans, even those of the Sublime Path, are granted the novitiate? Are you aware how hard these novices have to train and learn in order to just be allowed to enter the trial? We're not some group of tavern regulars which you can just join and leave on a whim. We are the Holy Order. We are what has kept peace in this country for millennia.
Good for you.
And only because Teela has doted on this idiocy of cycles and prophecies, he feels it's justified to abolish this country's foundations with a flick of his fingers. You, urchin child, you're the living proof of what has become of this country. Even just your boot prints on this sacred ground are blasphemy to everything we stand for.
My boot prints? Idiocy of cycles and prophecies? What, you still don't see that this is real?
What I see is a country that now more than ever needs peace, stability, and a strong leading hand. And transforming this order into a bunch of fortune tellers, wild mages and thimble riggers will only make the situation worse. Do you even know how many of our people were killed in the war Teela's fool of a son started? And now his former people, Pegast, Shaarim, whatever they call themselves, tread on these sacred grounds as if there were nothing more natural in the world. Now leave. Do what you want, but spare me your presence.
I'm not leaving. My boot prints, you say? Here, have some boot prints in your precious temple. Stamping them down nice and good for you.
Now, if it isn't the prodigy, well?
The green robe mages in the temple, is this your entire order?
Ha! We'd be a pretty pathetic order if that was all of us, wouldn't we?
Yeah.
No, only a handful of us came here. Let's just say the others weren't as thrilled by the idea of joining forces with our arch enemies. Especially if it's just to fight some phantasm, as they put it.
You mean the cycle? Then they don't believe it's real?
Not all of them. No.
Why? Didn't they have the dreams too?
Most did, but they didn't connect the dots. Or, which is more likely, didn't want to. And yes, I am frustrated to see that much ignorance in our own ranks. But those who matter are here. That's important.
Your order fought the Lightborn, didn't it? How do you feel now that they are rumored to be dead?
Quite some questions you're asking there, girl.
Yeah, sorry.
But why not? You're not one of those godlambs, so where's the harm in telling you? Yes, the Lightborn are dead, killed by the Shadowborn. But truth be told, too little has changed for us to feel any different. If that makes sense.
Too little has changed? There are wars all over Vin now. Just think about Nerim.
Yes, but that's because the Lightborn have left a power vacuum, and everybody feels obliged to fill it himself. Plus, there's the cycle, which seems to drive people into violence. I'm talking about grand-scale changes, such as in the way we think. To know that gods can be killed, that there is no other power in life than life itself. That has to do something with people, doesn't it? Well, bullshit. Just look around, Enderal. The most religious country of all. And yet, people act as if nothing has happened. All it needs is some fancily dressed up clergyman to tell them that the rumors are false. And they swallow it like mulled wine and go on about their business. It's depressing.
So there were rumors. I had a feeling this was kept like a closely guarded secret from all of them. That they never heard a thing about them, the Lightborn being dead. But I've noticed that too, yeah. So apart from the Order, the Lightborn being dead seems to have had hardly any impact at all. How do you explain that?
Well, I've been thinking about that. I suppose it's because the Lightborn's reign has always lived from people believing them to be divine, rather than actually being it. If that makes sense. They're more like symbols.
And you've helped to kill these symbols. Do you regret that?
Regret? Far from it. The gods were tyrants, and they robbed mankind of their right to self-determination. Regardless of the consequences, what we enabled the Shadow God to do was the right thing to do.
So it's not only Shadow Born, but there was a Shadow God? Well, thanks. Bless you.
Huh?
And then there's you, Yuslan. I've talked to him before. Alright, so we're to meet Calia. Talk to her about all this. And she's out of here. How foolish is it for us to question our life night and day? We will never find any answers, for we do not possess the divinity of our Lord, who is doing stuff.
The fig prodigy.
She's... what? Down here somewhere. In the school. This is where all these students died. Oh, she's practicing. Don't hit me with that.
Walk blessed. Can I help you?
Character? Not really. I just came to talk.
That's convenient, actually. I think I still owe you an explanation.
I don't know what the character little thing was. About old Dothulgrad, I take it? Dothulgrad?
Yes, but let's talk somewhere else. Come on.
Don't punch the post. It's very dark. I can't see. Hello?
Sorry for all the secrecy. I just didn't want anyone else to listen in.
I can understand that. So, what do you want to talk about?
Well, that moment when I neutralized the leader of the bandits in Old Dothulgrad. I'm sure you noticed that I was different then.
That's why I questioned you about it. I don't want to say she completely lost it. That's one way to put it. You seemed upset.
Upset. You choose your words carefully,
Sayara.
Oh,
she likes that one.
I appreciate that. I'll make this quick. There is something about me that you don't know. That no one knows, actually. Do you remember what I told you in the Curarium about the destroyed village? Well, I wasn't entirely honest with you.
It was her. So... you do know what actually happened?
Not all of it, no. And it's true that I don't know how I ended up there. But I remembered something just before I regained consciousness. Some kind of vague memory. A feeling coupled with an image.
A feeling? What do you mean by that?
It's hard to describe because it didn't last very long, but... I saw myself, but I was somehow... above the rooftops, as if I flew. Below me, I saw all the chaos. The dead, the fire, the devastated houses, and I somehow felt... hot, but from inside, as if my blood was boiling. That sounds crazy, doesn't it? I'm sorry, but I don't know how to describe it better than that.
That's where they all died. That's why old girl's smoking and stuff. I've been in here before. So that was... a memory? Something that really happened? I'm not sure I'm following.
It was something that actually happened, I'm sure of it. But the memory, it was somehow blurred. Like a dream, but a very vivid one.
So what happened then?
Nothing. I woke up, and from there things happened just as I've already told you. But that's not really what I'm trying to get at. In that memory, when I saw all those dead bodies and all that destruction, I felt satisfaction, pleasure.
Oh.
As if all that suffering, all that pain was the most exhilarating thing I'd ever seen.
So what are you trying to tell me?
Well, I didn't know what to make of that memory myself for quite a long time. But then, things happened that made me understand. There is something inside my head, Sayara. Some kind of second soul, an entity. Most of the time it sleeps, but there are situations in which it wakes up. Mostly when something atrocious happens or has happened. Blood, pain, death. Whenever I'm confronted with these kinds of things, it tries to... I don't know how to put it. Tries to take control of me. And then things like Old Dothulgrad happen.
Dothulgrad?
It's never managed to completely take me over, and it hasn't gotten as far as it did in Old Dothulgrad for a long, long time now. But that memory from the village, I think that is what happens when I let myself go completely.
Huh. So I'm guessing this power you suddenly had when you killed the bandit comes from this entity inside you?
Yes, it is. Immense, Sayara. I can feel it every time it is trying to take me over. I don't even want to think about what would happen if I were to give in completely.
So you have some kind of, like, demon inside you?
If that name seems fitting to you, then yes. But I think we both know these stories about ghosts taking over the living are just stories to scare the common folk. If it helps you, think of it as some kind of temptation. One that's just waiting for the moment when I am too weak to contain it.
So, it's a temptation is very different than saying it's like an entity within you. That's a lot to take in, though.
I figure. Listen, what happened in Old Dothulgrad? Should have let it come to that. But that moment when he charged me, the blood on his sword, I just couldn't contain it. And when I gave in, when I hacked him into pieces, I simply felt so thrilled. Complete. I was naive to believe it would never get that far again. Naive and stupid. But do you see now? This is the reason why I train so hard. Why I always try to control my emotions, no matter what people do or say to me. This creature inside me, it's always on the hunt. And the only way I can keep it at bay is by controlling both my body and spirit 100%. Just one moment of carelessness. That's all it takes.
If you were to let it take you over completely, what would happen?
I don't know. And truth be told, I'm not sure I want to.
Is there nothing you could do about this? No way to banish this monster?
No way that I know of, at least. Who should I ask? The apothecary? There are two ways that would go. Either they would ridicule me, or they would take me seriously and report my condition to the Order. Neither way helps me, and who knows what the Order would do if they found out. Especially as strained as the situation is right now.
So I'm not gonna ask this. So the villagers could have been right after all? Did you destroy that village?
I don't know, Saira. Believe me, I've asked myself that question more than 100 times. And as much as I hate to admit it, yes. There's a chance it did. I'll never find out.
Where'd the other the other thing disappeared?
I don't know. And truth be told, I'm not sure I want to.
But if violence provokes this thing, why are you with the military wing of the Order?
Well, what would be the alternative? Transcribe Pyrian books like the Magisters do all day? Or drop out entirely and pour hot water for the Upper City's noblewomen? Look, Saira, as you've already pointed out, there is a chance that this thing inside me is responsible for the massacre in the village. And if that's true, I definitely have a lot of repentance to do, don't you think? And even if it isn't, I want to change things, to make the world at least a little bit better. And yes, I do realize that this means a lot of hardship and hard work for me, but I'm not afraid of that. Do you know why? Because that's what's missing in this world. So many people just talk and never act, because that would mean that they'd have to actually endure something for what they believe in.
You definitely don't lack determination. I like it.
Determination alone hasn't helped anyone yet. Let's talk again in a few years, and we'll see if my good intentions have actually produced results.
You know, that was a compliment.
Well, that's good to know. I'd like some time by myself now. And thanks for listening.
You're very welcome. Butterflies in jars. So yeah, that's where it all happened.
100 times. The sky can rain fire. I just does never change.
Times. The sky can rain fire. Magisters never change.
Oh, okay. You're letting off steam. I'm gonna let you let off steam. Oh, wow. Okay. Second, I didn't realize I was standing on anything solid.
As if they'd ever listen to me.
Oh, they don't let you. Wee! Wee! It won't let me kill myself. So what do I have to do? Interlude. With the sigil stone and the beacon, we now have both the weapon as well as a defense versus the High Ones, the entities which are responsible for the cleansing as we know now and who appeared in my dream after the trial. However, it seems as if there was a worrying development. Arantheal convoked a meeting at which I have to participate. It should start in a day. Right, in the meantime, we got other stuff we can do. I'm not taking out this gargantua yet. Or these artifacts. Or the wishing wells. I haven't been to these areas yet. Biggest egg on. Yeah, I haven't been to those areas. Yeah, no fighting with the blood and dust. So dust pit. Isle of Kor, yeah, soon. Perhaps this. This is right where we were with the old rack. Oh no. I could just go to the Myra Tower in Fogville. Or I could go up that way. I think we can fight these things because we've been fighting them around here. Forget what they're called exactly. But they're what look exactly like Falmer from Skyrim. We came up here, went around the coast, and yeah. One or two of them started coming after us, so. Yeah, maybe I'll just go to the Myra Tower and just run all the way up there off screen and find my way back to the old rack and go from there. I still don't have much in the way of money, so I think I'm just gonna skip buying books for now. I'll be able to buy like one more, maybe two, so it's not gonna be much of a difference. So yeah, off screen, I'm gonna head there. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching, and always, seek adventure.